playing some No Man's Sky. So we are looking for S-class explorers, and we have noticed that with the newest update, there are new stats here to look at. So we can get a better idea of what we're looking at here. Now this is one of our S-classes already. We have a hyperdrive range of 1,276 with a 551.7 core. So that is going to be our gauge. We're looking for better than 551.7. Now, I have multiple explorers. I have multiple ships, and we are looking for a specific body style. You'll notice that this one is mine, transport, and it is the same one as that, Nemesis of the Wind. There are two large explorers that cycle through this station, and we are looking specifically for the other body style, which is the rare of the two. Now, while we do this, we're probably going to be doing some ship scrapping. As you can see, I've already gotten a couple taken care of. Now, when I do scrapping, I tend to focus on A's and S's only. Reason being is, as you can see here, I've already got 56,000 nanite clusters. Do I really only have 231 million? Which save am I on? That's because I'm on my survival save. That is correct. I have 231 million units. Got scared there for a second. I was like, what did I spend all my units on? While we do this, I'm going to grab the occasional A-class. Tend to do shuttles because they're a little bit cheaper. And one of the other tricks about... Now I have two slots available for ships, so I can actually grab two of them at the same time, but when I do this, I have learned that regardless of whether or not you do this and get rid of the superfluous gear, you still get the same scrap as if it still had those. So that's really just bonus material. Every time I buy one of these, I'm going to scrap those extra pieces. Okay, so here, scared me for a second there. I have two of my explorers here now because I forgot which one was the primary. What I'm going to do is I'm going to get rid of these guys. Real quick, and then I'll show you both of these explorers. Both are S-class, similar body style, but that's not the one that I'm looking for. I'm going for a third body style. Anybody that knows me knows I have a fondness for explorers, and I'm also fairly particular about them. As you notice, these are both symmetrical. Head run out here so we can take a good look. Okay, so this is transport S4821. And then this is Dora over here. You'll notice she has 2743, and there's the third body style right there that I'm looking for. this is what I'm looking for, but I'm looking for this in an S-class. And then that will be my three. So you notice all three of them are symmetrical. These two are fairly similar with a little bit different design. And then this tall body style with these nacelles. And then if you look at just how big this thing is huge. It takes up the entire space because it has these solar panels off the side. I have one, but it's an A-class, so I'm looking to replace it. So that's what we're going for right there, guys. That one, as she flies away. I am curious what the core on this was. Hyperdrive core 1123. I don't think that was right. Now let me show you how I have this one in particular decked out. So this one doesn't have as many slots available for transport. That's why the other one is named what it is, because I have these six spaces taken up. Emergency warp unit, an emerald drive, a cadmium drive, and then three upgrades. Now these can all get upgraded a little bit. 233, 236, 231. And then 237, 38, and 37. And then the hyperdrive and the indium drive. Whereas transport, let me show you transport real quick. Notice how it has all 48 slots available. And then I have it here, the hyperdrive, the warp unit, the indium. Currently has a 200, a 201, and a 228. That's why that is as low as it is. Fairly limited space, so I should probably get back in Dora, because she's the one that's going to always reappear when I get rid of a ship. Utilize her. Shift all of this over to her real quick. Yes, it has. How you doing? I saw you sent me an invite earlier, but I was already on this game, so I apologize for that. I wasn't quite streaming yet, but I was playing No Man's Sky. I will probably be on Apex a little bit later on tonight, if you're going to be around. Now here's one of the other cool things. Large fighter comes in here as well. Yeah, I got Mr. Mom duty until about 9 o'clock. A little bit after 9 when the wave gets home, that's probably when I'm going to switch over. So probably about 2 hours. Now just in case anybody is curious, you guys want, down on the lower left-hand side of the screen are the coordinates for the system. yourself an explorer or a large fighter. Grab this one real quick. Right on, dude. I'll shoot you a message. A-class shuttle, and we will scrap this one as well. And this is why I like having two slots available. So we have an S-class that just came in. We don't want to lose that. So let's go ahead and buy that. Real quick. So we'll get some S-class modules off of this scrap job. Should be a pulse engine and a hyperdrive. It's useful. In this one real quick. What is here around this guy? What we got there? A-class fighter. Okay, we've cleared the inventory. Scrap this one. This particular station has a decent number of S-class ships that pop through here, too. I know they're supposed to just be 2%, but high traffic. Short runway, high traffic. Turnaround's pretty quick. So this explorer right here was achieved, or was gotten at this particular location. This one was at another one. And I'm looking for that blue one to come through again. Now, if it doesn't make an appearance shortly, I'll probably have to do a reload of the autosave. Now, a lot of people just scrap any ship that comes through. Excuse me. I tend to go with the A's and the S's only because the value of the modules when you trade them back in for nanites. C's on average, you get like 60 to 75 nanites per. The B's, you get like 140 maybe. Whereas with the A's and the S's, you're in the 2s and 500s. 2 to 500, so while we're waiting for another batch of ships, let's go ahead and sell off some of these upgrades. Now that was 2. That's a whole bunch of shield modules. That's not what I meant to do. Apologies. Back to the exosuit. There's another S-class. This time a fighter. I'm always worried that if I reload my autosave, I'll miss specifically what I was going for. Because you honestly never know with the RNG. Stock up on wiring looms too. And any matter for that matter. No pun intended. I do like fighters because they tend to give you a whole bunch of modules. Also have 13 storage augmentations. Surprisingly enough, this is the first one of these that's come through on the stream so far, but I like that style of explorer. I'm really tempted to pick one up and deck it out. Like fully S-kitted out. very wide variety of shuttles come through here. Lots of little fellas. Let's pick up a fighter. This will be a little bit pricier. But that's okay. If we were really worried about funds, we wouldn't be scrapping ships just yet, would we? I've only seen one of the blue bodies come through, though, which is troubling. Normally, by now, it would be three or four of them have come through. So they're just not making rotation this time. Thank you. missing anything important while we do this. Sell off some modules real quick. The 304 was for a single. Wait and see what's coming in. Alright, so what we're going to do here is we're going to get in transport. Check that last ship that just came in. It's a B-class. Oh, we got a blue body coming in. I see it. So we're going to wait a moment. Now I have this fighter in S-class, which is why I'm not too concerned about that either. There's the blue one coming in now. There she is. It's just about to do a reload of the autosave, which we're going to do right after this blue, unless she's in S-class. If she's in S-class, we'll be happy. Nope, it's a B. So, what I was saying is we're going to jump in transport real quick. And then I'm going to reload the autosave. And I'm doing it from transport so that that ship comes back. And when I scrap one, Dora will come back and I'll have two ships there again. That way I can utilize storage from both.